Welcome back, dear students. I'm Kavita Sharma. I'm here to pick up threads from where I left in the previous video. You see, this being basic grammar, it is meant for both the standards, that is secondary as well as senior secondary. I hope you have thoroughly gone through delivered content and ready to receive more. Let's begin. Before coming on to today's topic, I would like to have a quick recap of our previous video. In the previous video, we had talked about classification of sentences based on word order and meaning. Today, we are going to take another classification of sentences based on clause structure. But I deem it better that you must know phrases and clauses before we switch over to our today's topic. So, phrase. Phrase is a group of words which make sense but not the complete sense. It does not possess a subject and verb. In the previous video, we had talked about sentences. Now you see, a sentence is a group of words which makes complete sense having a subject and verb. Here you see, phrase is also a group of words. Make sense but not the complete sense, and it does not possess a subject and verb. So only one similarity, that is both are group of words. Here we have a look at few examples. I will do it as soon as possible. Here you see, as soon as possible is a phrase. Now see, if we forget about this part, then what we see, as soon as possible makes sense but not the complete sense. Again, in this example, I stood beside the lake. Here you see, beside the lake is what? A phrase. As, it makes sense but not the complete sense. For complete sense, you have to what? Just consider this part, I stood. He left at 4:30. At 4:30 is what is a phrase. Now clause. Clause is a group of words which has a subject and verb, and it forms what? A sentence or a part of a larger sentence. Here you see in the example, he often visits Spain because he likes the climate. Here you see, this is one part. He often visits Spain. This is one part. And he likes the climate. This is what? The other part. And this whole is a sentence. And this whole sentence possesses two clauses. I know what he wants. Here, I know one part, he wants another part. What is a conjunction? And here in this sentence, because is a conjunction. So this is called clause. Now we come on to what our today's topic. Now see, classification of sentences based on clause structure. According to clause structure, as it is just what you visualize, that sentences are of four types. First one, we are simple sentences. Have a look at these few examples. The child laughed. Here you see, the child is the subject, laughed is the verb. One subject, one verb. Another example, she gives me expensive presents. She is subject, gives is verb, me is indirect object, expensive is direct object. But you see, only one subject and one verb. Somebody caught the ball. Somebody, subject, caught, verb, the ball, object. Again, you see, one subject and one verb. It means a simple sentence is one which contains only one subject and one verb. So, the second type of sentences are compound sentences. Here are few examples. I went to the station, bought a ticket and boarded the Jaipur train. Here you see, I is the subject, went verb. In the second part, again I is the subject, bought is the verb. In the third part, again subject and verb. Now see, there are three parts, three subjects and three verbs. See, all are what? Independent of each other. So, a compound sentence is one which contains two or more coordinating clauses. These following examples follow the same pattern. So, the question arises, what we mean by coordinating clauses? The clauses which are free and independent of each other, having equal rank and importance, are called coordinating clauses. So, now we move on to third type of sentences called complex sentences. Have a look at these examples. I teach because I like teaching. Here, I is subject, teach is verb, because is conjunction. I again subject, like is verb. See, two subjects and two verbs, so it cannot be a simple sentence. Because a simple sentence contains only one subject and one verb. Here, you see, I teach can stand alone. But because I like teaching, it needs what? Support of the first part. So this is called main clause and this is called subordinating clause. Now, a complex sentence is one which contains only one main clause and one or more subordinating clauses. Now, the question arises, what we mean by subordinating clauses? Subordinating clauses are those which depend on the main clause for the clear understanding of the meaning. Finally, we come on to the fourth type of sentences, complex compound sentences. Here are a few examples. I knew that he was ill, but I did not know that he suffered from cancer. Here you see, I knew, this is what? Main clause, that he was ill. This is subordinating clause because it depends on this main clause for the clear understanding of the meaning. Again here, I did not know, this is main clause, that he suffered from cancer. This is subordinating clause. A sentence containing two or more main clauses and at least one subordinating clause is called a compound sentence. Students, this is all on this topic. In the forthcoming videos, we shall be dealing with the tenses. I hope you are making best use of your free time and brushing up your skills. Stay tuned and stay safe.